I wanted to test out Kris Jenner's new cleaning line. It is called Safely. First of all, the bottles are gorgeous. So chic. Now let's put it to the test. Yikes, that is a nice spill. Spray, spray, spray. Whoa, it is like magic. You're doing amazing, sweetie. The smell is out of this world. Bible.
My weekly shopping trip to Target, I'm going to show you things you don't need but probably want. First, this No Bad Days pillow, it's only $5. This parsley grow kit, there's a bunch of different herbs as well. Spotted this cute monthly calendar, and these candles are so adorable. They come in a bunch of different sayings. They're only $3, and I think they're really fun. The Dollar Spot's fall dish towels are out. I think they did a great job. They're adorable. Next, these disposable toilet seat covers, how handy. This meal in a mug recipe book is so interesting. I think it could be a great gift. Next, these lampshade purses. I'm honestly not sure how to feel about them. And I'm trying to pick out a new backpack. Should I get this one or should I get this one? You guys tell me in the comments. I think they're both cute. They brought out their fall candles and I smelled every single one of them. No shame. I'm so excited. Then I went over to the home decor, found some really good things. These would be perfect in the kitchen with oil and vinegar. Also, I love this vibe for the bathroom. And lastly, I don't need another cup, but I thought these ones were really cute. This is what I picked up today. Follow me if you want to see more. Come shopping with me around Target in less than a minute. I always stop in the clothing first because it's right there when you walk in, and I picked up a new graphic tee. I also spotted this scrunchie, which is bigger than my head, for only $5. This really pretty set of earrings, and I loved all of the pastel sweatshirts. Next, these pajamas that I did not need, but I have no self-control, so they ended up coming home with me. This cute leopard bralette from Lively, and of course, new workout shorts to try and convince me to get to the gym. And nothing is better in adulthood than getting a new sponge. This one is so cute. And all of my organizing dreams have come true with this adorable line from Pillowfort. I forgot what a luxury it was strolling through the aisles of Target kid-free. Also, these doormats are so cute, but if I come home with another one, my husband will ask for a divorce. Anyways, this new candle line is gorgeous. My favorite was Daydream. It smells so good. And they brought out their new 4th of July line. Also, shout out to this Target since it's the first one I've seen out of the 6 I go to that is actually somewhat decorated. Another new candle line by Opal House. These are so cute with the tassels. And then at the end, I try and decide if I actually need anything and end up spending $200. My shower is so disorganized and I've been really wanting to get it looking good again. So that's what we're gonna do. The shelves are so dirty right now. I'm gonna clean them off and then get to organizing. Are you really even a girl if your shower wall doesn't look like this? I'm not gonna do anything fancy. I'm just gonna take off the hair with the shower head. The top on my shower cleaner broke, so you know the drill. Why I didn't just pour it on the washcloth, we will never know. Honestly, I despise cleaning my shower, so I'm just gonna wrap it up.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10, it's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and we'll go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot.
All finds from Walmart you need in your life. First are these Mums Inside Pumpkins, perfect for the front porch. The sugar cookie kit is a great activity for the kids. I loved all of their Halloween decor. It was so cute. We are having a little trick-or-treat party this year at our house, so I thought these items would be perfect for that, and they were inexpensive. They also had these tumblers that came in a few different designs for only $5.98. Snag this fall doormat for less than $12. Now moving on to beauty, they had a lot of festive items like these Wet n Wild lip scrubs, Pumpkin Spice shower gel, and these gorgeous Milani lipsticks. I grabbed shade Secret and it's a nice creamy mauve matte. Thought it was random to see Steal It in Walmart, but they did have their Stay All Day liquid liner. I also grabbed this Heritage scalp exfoliator to try. Found some dishware that stood out, like these bowls. They're a great size and just look at that price. Another favorite are the Mainstays candles. These are a great dupe for the Bath & Body Works candles for only $3.64. I also like these Halloween inspired candles along with these adorable spatulas. Hit that follow button if you want to see more affordable seasonal finds. I'm going to put you on to my 5 favorite and most used self-care items from Amazon that will change your life. This specific brand of hyaluronic acid, I don't know what kind of magic they put in it, but it is so good. I use it every single day and it has made my skin so plump. If you're feeling bougie and want to try a new moisturizer, let it be this one, the Tatcha Dewy Skin Cream. You know it's fancy when it comes with its own golden spoon to apply, but I love it. It's so luxurious, soaks into your skin. I have tried probably 80 to 100 moisturizers in my life, and this is top 3. If you struggle with headaches or puffy skin, you need these ice globes. They're gorgeous and they're less than $30. I love the way they feel on the skin, very cooling and such a relaxing thing to do. There's nothing better than listening to your favorite music in the shower. I have been loving this waterproof Bluetooth speaker. It's cool that you can hang it anywhere and the sound quality is really good. And last but certainly not least, I get questions about this the most. This is my starlight projector that I use while I shower. It is seriously magical. It will up your shower game and you will not regret it. Let's talk hairbrushes. I'm sitting on the floor cleaning out my brushes, and I just wanted to make sure you all knew the best hairbrush in the whole wide world. It's this one right here. This is the wet brush, specifically with the vented design. It's straight magic, I'm telling you. If you have kids, you need this. It will not hurt their heads. I have really long hair that gets tangled really easily. This never hurts me. And the best part, it's so easy to clean compared to my other ones. I do really like these brushes. However, they just collect so much lint and debris. I'm just not sold 100% on these as I am with this brand. And the best part, these are really inexpensive. They're less than $10. You can even find them at TJ Maxx sometimes for $5, which is great. So just keep an eye out, but I definitely recommend trying these out if you haven't already. They will change your life. So I know this is extra, but this was one of my favorite Christmas gifts this year. I think it's so unique and creative, and it's a great way to personalize things. So it's a wax stamp kit. I found some on Amazon, so I'll link them in my shop, but it comes with the envelopes, the tweezers, the wax spoon, all of the beautiful wax colors. Honestly, this thing is so unnecessary, but it's really satisfying, and I do think it gives that really nice personal touch, especially when you're sending out Christmas cards or if you're doing wedding invitations. Now that I think of it, I know I'm extra, but I don't think I'm that extra where I would be able to do hundreds of wedding invitations like this, but I do think it's really cute if you're in a long-distance relationship or if you just want to send out a few cards here and there. It's just a really cute touch. However, it is a little tricky. I feel like it takes some getting used to. I think I'm not the best at it, but my husband loves doing it too, and my daughter, and they did great at it. But can we all agree that love letters and pen pals are a long lost art that we should definitely bring back using this? I got some new organizers for my shower walls. They're called the Shower Gem. Let me show you how cool they are. I review products regularly, so I always need extra room, and I think this is the perfect thing to create extra storage in your shower. I have all my shower products laid out. I'm gonna get rid of the ones I don't use anymore and then divide them into sections. So we got James's section, hair treatments, body washes, my shampoo and conditioners, a few face products, and my favorite exfoliators. I'm hosting Galentine's Day this year, so I want to make a cute drink station for my girls. I cleaned out the hot cocoa station from Christmas. Now it's time to doll it up for Valentine's. I got all the cute and festive Valentine's Day candy, and I'm going to fill them in these jars. Now I'm gonna put all of these cute drinks on top of the tray. The cutest packaging definitely goes to this brand. It's coming together, but I kind of want to rearrange it a little just so I can fit these last drinks. I'm obsessed, I love it. We're almost finished. As you can see, there's two white heart containers, so I'm gonna switch one of them for the pink heart. I'm in love. I think it's so cute.
Reality of trying to film an ASMR grocery haul.
Shh. You can't even hear me.
Okay, do it one more time.
Shh. Your newest digestives. It will make you shit better.
I don't understand. Does it actually make you poop?
This is not a fridge restocker. I don't need those, man.
I want it to be like aesthetic, you know?
Golden Grahams is
not aesthetic.
Extremely aesthetic.
Throw one cup.
That actually came out perfect.
Okay. Dunkaroos type of cereal.
This is my favorite.
Best cereal, no argument.
We're not getting milk because we're actually...
I'm absolutely getting milk for my cereal.
This is going to be really expensive. Whole box.
Shh.
We have a lot of that. I'm telling you.
I don't... Oh my, just gently.
How expensive this is gonna be?
Why are you recording me like this? I feel very violated.
I got paparazzi over here. Can you just chill out?
Action.
Cancer. 100% cancer. 100% cancer. 200% cancer.
How much meat sticks did you need?
Only $5, man.
What? Can I just have a conversation with you?
What about Bitcoin?
You'd be financially free with Bitcoin.
It's on me, babe. Don't worry about it.
What's the damage? That was expensive.
Yeah.
What I was gonna tell you before was like Bitcoin.
Reality of trying to film an ASMR grocery haul.
Shh.
You can't even hear me.
Okay, do it one more time.
Welcome to your newest
digestives. It will make you shit better.
I don't understand. Does it actually make you poop?
This is not a freezer stock, but I don't need those, man.
I want it to be like aesthetic, you know?
Golden Grahams
is not aesthetic.
Extremely aesthetic.
Throw one cup.
That actually came out perfect.
Okay. Dunkaroos type of cereal.
This is my favorite.
Best cereal, no argument.
We're not getting milk because we're actually...
I'm absolutely getting milk for my cereal.
This is going to be really expensive. Whole box.
Shh.
We have a lot of that. I'm telling you.
I don't... Oh my, just gently.
How expensive this is gonna be?
Why are you recording me like this? I feel very violated.
I got paparazzi over here. Can you just chill out?
Action.
Cancer. 100% cancer. 100% cancer. 200% cancer.
How much meat sticks did you need?
Only $5, man.
What? Can I just have a conversation with you?
What about Bitcoin?
You'd be financially free with Bitcoin.
It's on me, babe. Don't worry about it.
What's the damage? That was expensive.
Yeah.
What I was gonna tell you before was like Bitcoin.
There's nothing I hate more than washing my makeup brushes, but these bad boys are long overdue, so let's get started. This stuff right here you can get on Amazon, and it's a miracle worker for cleaning your brushes. Take a paper towel. This is a quick drying solution, and they mean it when they say quick. Look at that. It literally looks brand new. It's amazing. I don't know how they do it. Three down, only 700 to go.
This is straight filthy, so just watch. Give him a little twirl, a little spin around the block. And now look at her. I'm getting weary. Just try two at a time. Ta-da! I'm gonna put my newly clean brushes next to my makeup mirror.
I feel like all of my eyeshadow brushes need their own spot.
And done. This is the best feeling ever.
Things to get the next time you're at Costco. Liquid IV came out with an energy multiplier in yuzu pineapple. It's delicious. It has natural caffeine, and these are awesome because they give you faster hydration than just water alone. I love these individually wrapped smoothie bags. They're convenient and the perfect thing to grab and go. I'm gonna start making my own acai bowls at home, so I grabbed these, granola, chia seeds, and frozen fruit. This rolling laundry hamper is my favorite thing. It's huge for $50 and perfect to roll around the house. You have to try the True Fruit chocolate covered strawberries. These are so good, but life is about balance, so I also got the prepackaged hard-boiled eggs. After you're done putting all of your new Costco finds away, grab a Liquid IV. There's so many flavors to choose from. I'm taking the energy multiplier to get rid of this afternoon slump. Here are my top makeup products from 2022 that I can't live without going into the new year. First, Summer Friday sunscreen. This is that glow from within, and it's the perfect step before your makeup. The Hollywood Flawless Filter by Charlotte Tilbury is an absolute yes. Makes you look airbrushed and healthy. I love this under foundation or on its own. You can't go wrong with it. My two favorite setting sprays, the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush. This will make your makeup last so long. The Tatcha Dewy Skin Mist does exactly what it says. Dewy skin, and it looks so gorgeous. For blush, we have Pixi and Rare Beauty. This is their tinted moisture stick. So easy to apply. I love the color. It's the perfect everyday shade. Here's some different shots so you can see it in different lighting. Next, we have Rare Beauty. I think this broke the internet. Everyone talked about it, but for good reason. It's so creamy, blendable, and look at that color. For bronzer, we have the Chanel Le Beige. I love the color of this. I use a stipple brush and it blends out really nice. It's a little bit more matte than my Rare Beauty one, and I think that's why this one wins out a little more. I use this all the time. I love how easy it is to apply. It's creamy and just gorgeous. For concealer, I have two very different formulas. I use the It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye when I need a lot of help and my bags are screaming. This is very full coverage and matte. For everyday, I use the Kosas Concealer. This is worth the hype. It is so gorgeous on the skin. It's just a major win for the dry skin community, so thank you, Kosas. Next, brow products. These two single-handedly saved my 2022. Just look at my brows in the next two photos. That is the doing of God's work and God's work alone, and I believe these were crafted by him. It just makes you look so fluffy and put together without trying. I got rid of my lash extensions for good reason, and these two are my saving grace. The Shiseido Eyelash Curler will lift you to the sky, and the Bad Gal Bang is the best mascara. It's an absolute must-have. I could not pick one highlighter, so I picked three. First, Rare Beauty. This is fairly new. I like this for every day because it's not like bam in your face, but looks pretty on the skin. Next, we have the Benefit Cookie Highlighter. This is so underrated. I love this one. It's definitely a ride or die. I just think, chef's kiss. Then we have Iconic London. If you want to be seen from outer space, this is your girl. Like, she's so pretty. Now, lips. Lips are very important to me. The Maybelline Vinyls are my favorite. I love the shade Koi. This is great for if I'm going out. Then we have the Tarte Lip Plumps. These are everything. I'm telling you, they make your lips look so good. This Hourglass palette has a chokehold on me. It's the only thing I want to use to finish off my makeup. You will look kissed by an angel. And last but not least, my makeup drying fan. I use this to dry down all of my products faster.
Finally, the moment I've been waiting for. It's shower organization time. I put up my shower gem organizers last night. These things hold so much stuff, so let's fill them up. I love testing out new products, and so on this side, I'm gonna do all body wash. My high school musical self is screaming. This is Ashley Tisdale's line. It's at Target, and all of her products smell so good. Way has some of my favorite products. The Melrose Place scent is divine. For the other side, I'm doing smooth skin products, so body scrubs and shaving cream. If you struggle with those little bumps on your arms, you absolutely need this. Exfoliating glove, hair scrubber, hair clip, wide tooth comb, body scrubber brush, and a razor. Now let's fill the other side. I'm just gonna do a whole row for Saltaire because I love their packaging. I got the scents Pink Beach and Seascape in honor of living by the beach now, which is so weird. I love the way these look, and the fact they have a pump is even better. This one is gonna be for a bunch of random products. Always like to have a face cleanser in the shower, a little yoni wash, a little detox or clarifying shampoo, a good hair mask, and lastly, these booster shots. Now for James' stuff. Perfect. And we're done. Let's make Christmas-themed charcuterie boards. These are the boards that I'm using, very festive. This is what I'm putting on them. I always do multiple different cheeses. Borzen and Brie are my favorite, they're must-haves. Prosciutto salami, the best crackers to ever exist, just get them. Some type of preserve, and then things you can easily grab. Starting with my Christmas tree board first, I'm taking a piece of pepper jack cheese and a star cookie cutter, using that at the top. For the base, I'm using pretzels, which is the perfect trunk. Boards are all about layering, the more the merrier. Starting with cucumbers, then working my way up with different cheeses, veggies, fruits. I want there to be a lot of interest, texture, and flavors. If you do that, you'll nail it. I'm getting hungry just looking at this thing. I'm really happy with how this one turned out. Now let's move on to the gingerbread man. He's just so cute. For the center, I'm using the garlic borzen, which is the only borzen you should get because it's delicious. For the face, I'm using olives and tomatoes. For his little hands, I'm using cheddar cheese. And then for the feet, I thought it would be so cute to use broccoli. They look like little Grinch feet. For the crackers, I just stacked them around the borzen. I'm very picky about what crackers I like. Any of the Nut Thins are my favorite, or Triscuits, specifically the balsamic Triscuits. Those are everything. A lot of flavor. For his panties, I use more tomatoes, and his sleeves, I use salami. He's all dressed and ready for the ball. I'm having a little Christmas party, so I put the boards on the coffee table because I like that people can just sit around and nibble instead of having to go to the kitchen. Then for the third board, I wanted to do something small. So in the center, I'm doing Brie cheese. Then I put little containers, one for the preserves and one for the crackers. And you're probably asking yourself, Kelsey, where's the caviar? I've been seeing that trending, and I just want to say you will never see that on my page. My palate is not sophisticated enough for that. It repulses me. I hate fishy things. Give me some Triscuits and salami, and I am a happy girl. That's why I keep my boards pretty simple. I just do things that I think will be universally liked by a lot of people. So this is how it turned out. I'm really happy. I think they look really cute and festive for the holiday season. And lastly, I'm wishing all of you a very Merry Christmas. Shower is clean, so now let's fill it with all my favorite products. This time I'm going to give James his own shelf because I'm a good wife. If you struggle with clogged pores or acne, get this body wash. It's not drying and it does a great job at keeping your skin clear. This body wash from Target is a literal dupe for Le Labo Santal 33. It smells amazing. Face wash. I have no clue if this man even uses shampoo or conditioner. I can't find it, so I'll just let him figure that out. My hair has been really dry recently, so I'm trying out a new shampoo and conditioner. This is the Pureology Hydrate line. If your hair gets greasy easily, you need this. I got it off Amazon. Look up the reviews, they're incredible. When my hair has a lot of product buildup, these are my two favorite clarifying shampoos to use. Over on this shelf, I'm gonna do hair treatments. My hair lives for this mask. I'm obsessed. It makes my hair so shiny and I can't get over the smell. For when my hair really needs a good scrub, this is what I use. I feel like these speak for themselves and need no explanation. This next shelf is going to be for my face products. I love IT Cosmetics, and this cleansing balm is super nice. Nothing like a fresh new tube. Love any Murad products. This Naturium cleansing oil. Any products that have a pump like this make my life so much easier. It's really convenient, perfect for the shower. Now for my favorite shelf, body scrubs and polish. Best body scrubs, no question. Inexpensive, have so many different scents, and they make you feel like a dolphin. Just trust me on this one. It's from Amazon and I promise you won't regret it. Just look at it. Nighttime body scrub that literally warms up on your skin. I don't love a lot of this brand's products, but this stuff right here, this one can stay. Last but not least, body wash. best shaving cream, and you can get it at Walmart. Now for shower accessories, if you will. My amazing silicone body scrub brush. Everyone needs a scalp stimulating brush. The Billy razors are by far my favorite. I like to have a wide tooth comb to get out any tangles. Hair clip and a few hair ties are a must for me. A little toothpaste and toothbrush. And we're done. James and I make a competition out of everything. It doesn't matter what it is, we are competing over it. Our daughter starts kindergarten tomorrow, so naturally we're gonna compete over who can make the best lunches for her. We're gonna switch off each day, but I know I'm going to win this challenge. There is no competition. I love being creative and making things extra special for her. For her first day of school, I'm making a rotisserie chicken pickle wrap. I used mayo and honey mustard on the bottom, rolled this up and thinly sliced it. It's like a little sushi roll. I know she's gonna love it. I'm already starting to prepare myself because I just know I'm gonna be an emotional wreck. She will be gone all day, so it's gonna feel like an empty house. I'm gonna miss her so much, but I'm also so excited for her to learn and grow. This bento box I got from Pottery Barn, and it is so awesome. It fits a lot of things. It has a lot of different compartments. For her sides today, I gave her some cheddar bunnies. I love this little compartment you can store dips in. She's a big fan of hummus, so I cut up some cucumbers so she could dip them. And for dessert, I got these from Costco. They look delicious. I also included a Rice Krispie treat because remember, I'm trying to win this challenge and win over her heart. I got these adorable picks off Amazon. I thought it would just be a fun little surprise when she opens it. That's everything I packed for food for her first day of kindergarten. I included a note, even though I know she can't read. Maybe one of her teachers will be nice enough to read it to her. But I'm really looking forward to this new chapter, making her lunches and coming up with fun and exciting recipes.
restocking on some of my favorite products from Ulta. First is the Fenty Beauty Gloss Balm. My favorite shade is in Fussy. It is so good. I just think it's the perfect everyday shade and I wear it all the time. I think Shape Tape is so drying, so instead I love the Too Faced Born This Way. It's still full coverage, but more dewy. I picked up my favorite mascara from Benefit, Bad Gal Bang. This stuff is great. I love the flexible wand and it gives me amazing length. They also have amazing brow products. I love their Precision Brow Pencil. It definitely gives hair-like strokes. It's expensive, but worth it. Okay, just buy this. If you get those red bumps on your arms or your legs or wherever, this stuff seriously works to remove them. This is like blotting paper, but better. It's reusable and it's great for on the go if you get oily on the face. I love Ava NYC products, their primer, their mask, and then I picked up another one of their flexible hairsprays. I love the Acai line from Truly. I've used up a few of their containers, so I picked up another. And then this one is a new one I haven't tried, so I'm gonna give it a go. Grab some lashes for my trip to Nashville. These ones say no adhesive needed. You put them in water and apply. That sounds so cool to me. Have you tried? And lastly, the best hand sanitizer to ever live. This stuff smells incredible and it's so hydrating on my skin. I will never go back. And that was my haul of everything I picked up at Ulta. Naturally, I want my bedroom to feel like a 5-star hotel. So let's organize and stock my nightstand. Here she is now. Definitely not my proudest moment, but we just gotta trust the process. Let's take everything out first. Like, why are these even in here? Three of these fit perfectly across, so now it's time to fill them up. My bedside table has officially become a concession stand.
Welcome back to my ADHD organizing and a rare look inside my brain. If you remember correctly, this is where we last left off. I started two closet organizing projects at the same time, got too overwhelmed, didn't want to do it anymore, so I gave up. But we're back, baby. Does the nesting mode have an expiration date? Because I'm 29 weeks pregnant, feels like 100, getting more miserable by the day. Maybe it's Maybelline, maybe it's depression. But I'm trying not to be a big baby and get things done. You guys gave me a great idea to switch this closet up, so thank you for that. This really is a team effort. Since the cube storage ended up fitting in the other space, I went on to Amazon, ordered another utility shelf to match for this closet, and my hips were so grateful because I had 2 delivery days to recover from all of the bending. Now sit back, relax, enjoy some music while I restock all of the supplies I'm using in this closet. I'm gonna go catch my breath and grab my Tums.
Doc told me to travel, but there's COVID on the planes, and I heard Vermont, but it's the season of the sticks, and I saw your mom, she forgot that I existed, and it's half my fault, but I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends come home for Christmas, and I'll dream each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now your tire tracks in one pair of shoes, and I'm split in half, but that'll have to do.
God, I love Noah. Okay, now we're labeling things. This is one of my prized possessions. I must say it's not only handy, but quite fun. Now, we're a family of 3, so why we need a 1,000-piece cutlery set is beyond me. But I'm throwing it in a bin and calling it a day. This is a water bottle organizer, but it actually works great for organizing your wipes. So basically, this closet is great if we have an apocalyptic event, because we are stocked. I am using these baskets for important things, like washcloths, hand towels, kitchen towels. You get it. I may not have a car seat or, I don't know, a bassinet for my baby to sleep in, but I do have 12 dish soaps, so I'm feeling prepared. For the towels, I put them right when you walk in. I love easy access to those. And then for the beach towels, I put them in their own Tupper basket. We're storing our sheets in here. We don't have very many, so those went right on top, and our mop bucket fit perfectly on the bottom. As far as boring spaces go, I feel like this space checks all of the boxes. It definitely doesn't scream the most aesthetic, but everything functioned, and I am content with that. I'm just happy I can finally see the floor.
Today I'm organizing baby boy's dresser. I'm gonna start with his clothes. We're gonna cut off all of the tags, throw them in the washer, and then sort them by size. Why do they put so many dang tags on these things? We get it. Look at these precious little Jesus sandals. I got Kenzie and her brother. I almost keep slipping and saying his name. I cannot wait to see them in this matching set. I think this would be perfect for family pictures. I'm also gonna do a load of all of his swaddles, blankets, and burp cloths. Everything is washed and put into piles by size. Now let's put them into the drawers. Unfortunately, this is what his drawer looks like currently, so let's get them cleared out. I still need to order his changing pad, which is gonna go on top of his drawer, but for now I'm just gonna clear everything off. Everyone needs a label maker. We got ours at Costco for really inexpensive, and they just are so satisfying. Don't worry, I flipped it around because the Honest was upside down. I still have so many little baby essential items I still need to get, but I'm gonna store all of his health-related items in here. I've only accomplished one drawer so far. It feels like it's taken me forever. I'm gonna do a part two, so go check it out. I'm 30 weeks pregnant with our first baby boy, and we are not doing a nursery. Instead, we will be room sharing with him, most likely for the first year. I figured it was time to get our room in order for him. We ordered his personalized blanket. Yes, that's his middle name after his dad. We have so much to get done before he gets here. I ended up just transferring OBGYNs because our last place had blood on the floor from the previous patient that they never cleaned up. When I went back a week later, it was still there, so that was a cause for concern. So now I'm at a new doctor. We just had an ultrasound, but unfortunately, baby is so low into my hoo-ha that they can't see his head, so they weren't able to get an accurate read on his brain. So hopefully it's functioning okay. Just to be cautious, they're sending me to a high-risk clinic to do further testing. He's already 4 pounds and feels like he could fly out of me at any second, which I never experienced with our daughter. So I said, James, let's get our shit together because who knows when he's popping out. I finally ordered the matching nightstand for James's side. We took the dresser that was originally here and put it against the wall where our TV is. This is going to be baby
baby station. We're going to put his changing pad up here, his diapers, all the baby essentials. He will be in a bassinet next to our bed. I've been doing research on all of them, but if you have one you love, please let me know. I'm leaning between the Four Moms or the Halo bassinet. To be completely honest, it's hard for me to find a care about anything, let alone home decor right now. So I haven't added any personalization to our room since we moved in. So I'm finally adding some pictures, trying to make it feel homey and cozy for when he arrives. My nesting mode has been slowing down. Pregnancy insomnia has been kicking my butt. So tired, I feel swollen, ugly, gross, my body hurts. We're just ready to meet our son. I cannot wait for this new chapter. I'm gonna organize his clothes next, so come back. Nest with me, part two. This is the chaos I'm working with. I'm tired, I don't wanna do this, but I promised myself I would, so we're gonna get it done. Already organized the top drawer, now we're moving on to the middle. Labels and organizers are in place, so now we can start filling.
I found this pack of little hats on Amazon. These are gonna be great, especially in those early newborn days. I only got a few pants. We live in Florida and it'll be in the summer when he's a little one, so I don't know how often he'll wear them, but I'm just gonna store them in here for now. Middle drawer done. Last and final, and I cannot wait to be done. For the bottom drawer, I'm gonna be storing blankets, swaddles, and miscellaneous items. I'm putting these bins in here, and then I'm just gonna use one of these dividers. I used the Boppy pillow with Kenzie and loved it. I'm just gonna switch out the cover. I found this one on Amazon for 10 bucks. Ooh, this is way softer than the original one. I thought it was so cute with all the different animals. I got a few of the Solly baby wraps. These are awesome. They are perfect for those early newborn days when you just can't put them down. I love this print. We use these with Kenzie and they just work really well once you get the hang of it. The Velcro swaddles are an absolute necessity, I'm telling you. If you're a first-time mom, these are the ones. Then I just have a section for miscellaneous, so I'm gonna store extra things that I have, like boogie wipes, some baby toys. Bottom drawer done. I still have so much to do and get, but we have made progress and that's what matters. Now I'm gonna go lay flat. Bending over is not ideal. Our baby boy is gonna be born in just a few months and we have yet to prepare anything. Second child problems. I figured I should probably get started on preparing for his arrival. So today I'm gonna put together his diaper cart. The only thing I have been getting so far is clothes because they're just too cute to resist. Like, are you kidding? This is so precious. With Kenzie, I bought so many unnecessary things. So this time I'm trying to be more mindful. And I mean, let's be honest, girl clothes are so much cuter, but I won't lie. I cannot wait to dress him. What I remember with our first baby was they only wear sleepers all day, every day for the first few months anyways. So I've stocked up on those. I did a Target pickup order for a lot of the essentials for the diaper cart. This is gonna stay in our living room and I just figured it would be easy to roll around everywhere. Here are some of the things I'm gonna put on the cart. I remember using these a lot with Kenzie. Boogie wipes. Gripe water was a miracle worker. Aquaphor, a lot of hand sanitizer. Gotta have diaper rash cream on hand. I got the Frida Baby saline mist. I've never tried it, but it's good to have. Ken's never had any issues with wipes or sensitivity to things, so we're gonna try these out and hope for the best. I use the muslin swaddle blankets all the time and we love them, so I got a set for him in this really cute Winnie the Pooh print. Solly Baby is so awesome. Their fabric is to die for. It is incredibly soft. So I got this really pretty checkered swaddle. For diapers, I'm not 100% yet, but we use the subscription service for the Honest Diapers. I loved them because they have so many cute prints. They show up at your door. It's just very convenient. It's not the most affordable, but if you have a diaper suggestion that you're like, Kelsey, you have to try, please let me know. Having such a large age gap between our kids makes me feel like a first-time mom again. Especially with all of the new gadgets and gizmos out there now, I'm just like, where do I even begin? But what I do remember is that babies actually don't need a lot. Logically, it makes sense that they don't need a lot, but everything is just so cute nowadays. All right, time to get this cart filled. I cannot get over how small these are and the fact that we're gonna have a little baby that fits in them. I can't. I only bought a few Binkies so far because I'm not sure what he's gonna like, but these ones had so many reviews on Amazon. I just could not resist these ones. For the second bin, I'm gonna do some swaddles. I haven't got a diaper changing pad yet, so I need to do that. And then I'm gonna put some onesies and maybe sleepers just in case he has a blowout. I need to take off all the tags and wash everything, but I'm just gonna put them in here for now. I adore the Burt's Bees onesies. You will never catch me without a zippered onesie because I do not have time for all those snaps. I also forgot I'm gonna add some burp cloths. These literally come in handy at any second. He won't be using these for a while, but when the time comes, these are good to have on hand so that he can entertain himself. I got this cool weighted wipe dispenser, so I'm gonna put this on the bottom and then all of our extra wipes. I think it's done for now. Of course, I'm gonna be adding things throughout the next few months. If you guys have any suggestions of something I have to have, please let me know. I'm so excited and I can't wait for him to be here.
Let me take you through a day in my chaotic brain of trying to get organized with zero motivation and zero skill. Today's project is the perfect example of what not to do. This closet has been haunting me. It's supposed to be our linen closet slash supply closet. It's underneath the stairs, so it's really awkward. Honestly, I started this project with no vision or plan, which I don't recommend, because then you just create bigger chaos in your life. But all I knew was I had to clear the clutter, so we took everything out, got it vacuumed, and then we could see a clear picture of what we're working with. I bought some organizers, we got them in the space, and then I realized I hated it. So now that I've removed everything from that space and it's all over my house, I saw another closet that needed my attention, so I figured what better time than now to get this one done. I don't even know what this closet is for. I mean, we had our gingerbread house and Halloween candy from last year, so clearly some very important things. I'm 28 weeks pregnant with the back of a 97-year-old and my mom has vertigo, so clearly we're a really great pair to be doing all of this. We moved the organizer that didn't work in the other closet up here, hoping for the best, and reorganized the gift wrapping.
I wasn't sure what I was looking at. I kept thinking, are they doggies?
They were in fact not doggies, but great wrapping for a bachelorette party, if I do say so myself. Okay, moving along. I had these bins, and I thought it would be great to organize my seasonal decor, things like 4th of July, Easter, Valentine's Day, you get it. And this was the part of the project I felt pretty good about. Everything was coming together, or so I thought, until we realized, you know what, we probably should have measured to make sure our organizers fit in here. Guess what? They didn't, which really hurt my perfectionist heart. So now I have two unfinished closets. So now my house is worse off than when it started because shit is everywhere. So the moral of the story, just don't try.
Thank you.